Alright, what the hell is going on? I'm sure some of you won't be confused. Why is this titled Street Fighter V when I'm looking at Risk of Rain? Because I'm too lazy to hook up my Xbox and all the stuff involved with that and the capture card and everything so that I can record a Street Fighter 4 screen so that it was appropriate for the topic. And so instead, you want to listen to this soothing-ass Risk of Rain stuff. Well, so talk about Street Fighter 5. Now, the first thing I'm actually kind of thinking is, like, everybody was kind of talking about Omega Mode of Street Fighter 4. Gonna get on a little tangent here before we talk about Street Fighter 5, but this is related, I promise. Everybody was like, yo, like, why are you doing Omega Mode? What's the point? Cool, it's a free update, that's great, but, like, if I feel like this is time wasted, you know what I mean? Like, this, you know, that's what, I didn't think that. I was like, ah, that looks cool, that'll be fun, I'll play it, why the fuck not? But that was a topic of discussion that came up quite often in relation to Omega Mode. And so now, like, actually seeing Street Fighter V, I first thought of it, obviously, when I saw the gameplay trailer. But now that they had this, I'm recording this after Capcom Cup is over. And they had the Street Fighter V exhibition between Mike Ross and Combo Fiend. And firstly, let me just say, I hope they speed that bitch up. I really hope, because it reminded me of Mortal Kombat in that everything was kind of like awkwardly slow. The animations, the hit stop, everything was just weird and unnecessarily slow in motion. And so, like, I really hope they speed it up a little bit. Obviously, you can't take too much of a judgment away from this. It's obviously a very early build. It doesn't really have anything, you know, everything could change. But back to Omega Mode, I feel like that was a test, this is a test, to see what the general response is to how Omega Mode works, because I feel like Omega Mode and the design behind it, and what's comboable, what isn't, how special moves seem to have, like, a series of hits to all of them, rather than just, you know, how they kind of are now, and I feel like that was kind of like a precursor to Street Fighter V, to how Street Fighter V looks in motion and how everything seems to be going and interacting. And so I'm kind of thinking, you know, they're going to this is like a preliminary look at what they want to make Street Fighter V. But if everybody's kind of just like dismisses Omega Mode and is like, eh, whatever, you know, we don't really like it, don't really dig it. Let's just get rid of that and move on. Then, you know, they may change the game plan entirely. But that's actually, now that I, you know, see that, I feel like that is definitely the point of Omega Mode. That's why Omega Mode was made as it is because it is more similar in, you know, general scope to what they play in Street Fighter V to be. Now, I have to admit, I'm not huge on what I saw in Street Fighter V. But a large part, again, I can't really sit here and trash it all that much because it's like as early of a playable build as you can get. Obviously, there's a lot of things that need tightening up. There's a lot of things that are gonna be changed, blah blah blah. So there's really no point in, like, getting into it overly much. But I have to say, from what I saw, if I had to choose between playing Street Fighter 4 or Street Fighter 5, I would pick Street Fighter 4 at this point. But we'll see, obviously, as it goes along. But let's fucking talk about $500,000 grand prize win to next year's Capcom Cup. Holy shit. Like, that's big. That's very big. That could blow the community up. Like, people could hear about that and be like, oh, shit. I mean, even if it is just a bunch of people trying to get into it for the money, it could still draw a lot of extra attention to Street Fighter. And when you look at Street Fighter, it could be a doorway into fighting games in general. I don't really know if I've talked about this previously, but Street Fighter 4 was my first fighting game. That was the first fighting game I ever took even remotely seriously. Not the first one I ever played. Obviously, I had tooled around with stuff like Dead or Alive. I'd played, you know, Street Fighter 2 when it was in the arcades when I was a kid. You know, you'd go to the pizza place and you'd run into the arcade machines and stuff like that. I'd played fighting games before, but I'd never taken one seriously and actually tried to play other people in it before. And so Street Fighter 4 was the first fighting game that I played, and it got me to look into other fighting games. which obviously led me to Blaze Blue. Blaze Blue was the next big release of a fighting game after Street Fighter 4. Then obviously you had Marvel vs. Capcom 3, King of Fighters 12. Actually, it was unfortunate that that game was a piece of shit, but then they redeemed themselves with King of Fighters 13. And so the reason why I'm into fighting games now, the reason why I would say fighting games are is either my second favorite. I'd have to do like a deep some deep introspection to decide what my favorite game genre actually is, but it's definitely either RPGs or fighting games. And I have spent a copious amount of hours on fighting games ever since playing Street Fighter. So, you know, even if it is just a bunch of people looking into it, thinking, yo, I'ma get that money, son, it could lead to a bunch of people sticking around and growing the fighting game community, and then, you know, people branch out, looking to other things. Like, this can really only be a good thing, so I'm really excited about that. I'm very glad that they've stepped up the efforts of, you know, the reward and the scope and potential of fighting games in the future, because it's really, if more, you know, if more people obviously get involved, that means higher pop bonuses, that means, you know, more like money match opportunity, everything. It grows, it expands, and that can only be a good thing. So that's a pretty exciting announcement overall, not just because, holy shit, $500,000 for winning a video game tournament, but because of all the implications it has as well. So I'm really hyped for that. I'm very excited that Capcom and Sony are stepping up like that. So let's actually talk about, that's another thing in Street Fighter V. A lot of people are like, why is it only coming out on PS4 and PC? Why isn't it coming out on PS3 or the 360? Like, motherfuckers, are you real? This game ain't gonna be out till like 2016. Nobody's gonna be supporting Xbox 360 or PS3 anymore after that. Sorry, I thought I heard something. If it came out tomorrow, obviously it's arguable that it could be a mistake to not release it on current generation platforms. But when it's coming out 2 years from now, they're considered last generation now. That's going to be a mindset that's going to take me a while to get out of. It would make sense for them to be on last generation platforms if it came out this holiday season or next spring or some shit. But, like, 2016, maybe, like, you know, if they all take, like, as much speed and crack as humanly possible, and they're going to lose, like, half of their developers because they're going to drop dead from overdoses and shit and overworking and stuff, and they may be able to get it out by the end of 2015. But otherwise, you're probably not going to see that game until late 2016. So I can't. It blows my mind how short-sighted the majority of people are, thinking that, like, releasing it that late, two years from now, a year and a half from now, whatever, that 360 and PS3 are still going to be getting support to begin with. And the other thing, actually, you know, the story about the boss, the head, I don't know if it was like the CEO of Microsoft, Phil Spencer, I think is the dude's name, came out and was like, hey man, it's okay, we got Killer Instinct. I'm just sitting like that. Motherfucker, please. Like, didn't that game have one of the fewest entrants at Evo? Did that thing even get main stage attention? Maybe top 8, top 4, or something like that? It did. Early in the morning, I remember that. Which was, I haven't really been outspoken in regard to my feelings about Killer Instinct, but I don't care about it. There's nothing about it that I really like. I don't particularly like the animation. I don't particularly like how it looks, how it plays. But most of all, I hate the business model that surrounds the entire thing. Like, I'm perfectly okay with the potential of the business model, with the fact that you can purchase this game, you have a fighting game, and then you can pay for characters. So that potentially, if you download this game and you like Jago, and you want to main Jago, you basically just got an entire fighting game for free. However, my problem with it is the fact that, as far as I am aware, you can't try out the other characters. There's no way to test the other characters. So you're basically rolling the dice when you pay for and download a character that you're going to like them. And if you don't like them, if you don't want to play them, and we've seen me in fighting games, I go through just almost every character in the cast trying to see, you know, like, do I really like this one? Do I not like this one? What's going to happen here? You know, I don't know. So I would want to try out every single character. I'm not going to spend money to try out a character that in all likelihood I'm not going to end up playing. So that's the part that gets me, is that there's no way to just, like, take this character into training mode and just screw around with them and figure them out and then be like, okay, this is definitely a character. Even if it's like a 30-minute trial, like you get 30 minutes with the character or something like that. Anything more than just pay for this character and hope you like them. So that's what really I don't like about Killer Instinct. But either way, believing that you can build up Killer Instinct to anything even comparable to Street Fighter is just silly as fuck. Like, that dude has got to be just slamming his head into a brick wall over and over over losing Street Fighter V. Because that is going... I mean, it's just a simple fact. Street Fighter is the biggest fighting game series. Well, nah, that's not correct. Mortal Kombat, I think, actually sells more. But in terms of, you know, like, actual fan dedication, in terms of, like, you know, the competitive scene, which actually draws attention to the games and all that shit, Street Fighter is just leaps and bounds ahead of anything else. Everything. Smash. Yeah, Smash in there. Smash has got a pretty big community. But it's still, I think Smash still only got around half the entrants that... No, they got over 1,000, didn't they? I think they had around like 1,100 and Street Fighter had around 1,700, if I'm remembering correctly, at Evo. But Smash is definitely the closest. Killer Instinct got like, what, maybe 400? Maybe 600. I mean, obviously, I wasn't paying extremely close attention, so I have no idea exactly how many people got into that game. But yeah, it's just... Losing Street Fighter on your console is huge, and a lot of people believe it's because they refuse to make it a cross-console, like, connection with everybody, which is what I believe they've said. I mean, I haven't looked into it deeply enough. Like, I'm not interested enough to, like, delve into everything to do with Street Fighter V when it's so far away, but from what I've heard, they've said there'll be support between the PS4 and the PC so that you can connect with each other so the communities aren't divided. And so that's kind of a prevailing theory of why they didn't get it on the Xbox, is because they said, no, we're not going to do that. We're not going to, I guess, help our competitors maybe or whatever. They just said they wouldn't support that. And so they were like, oh, okay, well, then we don't want to be on your console. We'll just stick to the PS4 and the PC, whatever. But because of that deal, it's now led to a $500,000 tournament series next year, which is, like I said, I can't think of words positive enough to describe the effect I think that'll have on the overall fighting game community. And I really hope it, you know, reaches that high point and just keeps going that I'm thinking of. Obviously, there's no way in hell I could, despite what my tweets might imply, there's no way in hell I can make that. In a year's time, you think, you know, like, you're gonna be good enough to beat the people that took place in this year's Capcom Cup? Nuh-uh. You know, it's possible to get to the point where you can start actually competing with them, where you can actually play them without just getting bodied so hard you're bleeding from your ass for the next, you know, 2 weeks. Which does happen quite often if you play a fighting game that you're not great at against somebody that is great at it. But, you know, in a year's time, you definitely start to get that feeling of being capable of hanging with these people. But, you know, push comes to shove, they're going to beat you more than you're going to beat them, and it just requires constant playing against that level of competition in order to get to the point where you can start trading games with them rather than getting, you know, one out of every three or one out of every four or whatever. Obviously, it would be fucking amazing to go and win that and win $500,000. It's not going to happen. I'm not good enough. But still, like, that is a life changer, to be perfectly honest. That's great. Like, kudos to them. So that's basically it. That's all I gotta say. Street Fighter V. Hope it shapes up and looks and ends up being the best game ever. Alright, bye.